Good evening, guys. In the process of providing solutions for exam conducted today, CSIR NET 2017 December exam. So I'm providing solution for unit 2, complex analysis. First question, 33rd. I have booklet code B, question number 33. The question is, I'll read out the question. We are given, I'll explain, it is already written there. I'll explain the question that we have two regions in complex plane. One is D, which is unit disk. Another is U, which is obtained by removing 2 points from the disk, minus half and half. So I have two domains, two sets, D and U. Now, the question reads out that we have two sets, H1 and H2, both are collection of functions which are holomorphic on their respective domains. H1 is set of functions which are analytic on D, and H2 is which are analytic on U, holomorphic on the corresponding domain. Along with this, there is another information, the functions are bounded as well. Now, there is no problem with H1, it is set of all functions which are holomorphic on D, unit disk. Here, the H2, the domain is U, which is D minus these 2 points. So, H2 is collection of holomorphic function on U, and if we see, then in U, minus half and half are not there. But in a neighbor of these 2 points, the function in H2 are bounded. And by Riemann's theorem, if a function is bounded in a neighbor of a point, say alpha, then alpha is either removable singularity or f is regular at alpha. So here, so these 2 points are not there, but certainly we can say the function in H2 are having removable singularity at minus half and half. Now, let's discuss the further. Now, they have defined a function from H1 to H2 as RF of F, restriction of F over U. So, and the question talks about whether this function R is 1-1 onto injective, surjective, etc. Let us see here whether it is injective or not. So, R of F, suppose R of F equal to R of G, I take F and G are member of H1, that is they are analytic on D. By rule, it is FU equal to GU. It reads out that F and G are analytic on D. F and G are analytic on D and agree on U. It means F and G are analytic on D and agree on U. And identity theorem says if F and G agree on a set which has limit point, then they are identical. So this implies F must be equal to G for all Z belongs to D. That means F equal to G. So R is injective. That is 1-1. Another converse part, that onto, if I want to prove whether F is onto or not. So let H belongs to H2, suppose. That means what? H is from U to C, and H is analytic. Now, as H is bounded in a neighborhood of minus half and half, it means at these 2 points, say limit z tends to minus half, hz exists, because by Riemann's theorem it is analytic in a deleted neighborhood of minus half and half. I have taken minus half here, so its limit must exist, either removable singularity or regular, but limit must exist. Say it is L. Now I define fz equal to hz when, and similarly L1, and limit h tends z tends to half hz equal to L2. I define hz when z is not equal to minus 1 by 2 and half, and L1 when z equal to minus half, L2 when z equal to half. Then this f is analytic in D, and f u equal to h, f u equal to h u, and hence phi of f is nothing but h. So not phi, that is r here, they have given r. So this implies r is onto as well. So this is simple example of Riemann's theorem and identity theorem. In the first part, when I have created these two, I claimed since rf equal to rg means f restriction over u equal to g restriction over u, that means f and g agree on u. What is u? D minus 2 point. So f and g agree on d except 2 point minus half and half, and h and f and g are analytic, holomorphic on d, so they must agree at minus half and half as well. So f equal to g, so it is injective claimed. And for onto, I use Riemann's theorem. How I proved here? Since h is analytic at on u, that means minus half and half are not in u, but h is defined and analytic in a deleted neighborhood of minus half and half, but given bounded as well. So at half and minus half, they must have removal similarity, so they can be extended to analytic functions. So I have extended f, this h is called as f, which is analytic in this, and here now this f is analytic in d, and now by definition r of f must be this h only, so this is onto as well. So answer is 3. Correct answer is option 3. You can check your other booklets and get the answer. Thank you.